Oh, goody. My, one second. My broadcasting software decided to completely mess with my webcam layout, so I'm just over off in the corner. Sorry, everyone watching. I swear, as soon as I, when I hit preview, right before starting this, it was good, and OBS just decided it wanted to do something new here. I don't know why. Okay, here, well, let's fix this real quick. One moment. Let's get that into place. Very, very great, OBS. All right. There we go. Sorry about that, folks. Okay. So, today, everyone, we're going to be playing some Gran Turismo Sport. It's actually not released yet. It will be releasing tomorrow, October 17th. So we get a little bit of an early look here. And before we get into playing, I'm actually joined by the U.S. senior game producer. His name is Taku Imasaki. We'll just talk a little bit about the game. Thanks so much for coming on.
Hello. Thanks Hi for having me.
So, I assume with this releasing tomorrow, a lot of excitement, right?
Oh, and yeah, and of course stress. We're a big company, so
yeah. I'm like, man, this is dropping in like a few hours, and you're on a call with me. You must have your phone like ringing off the hook.
Yes, yeah, you should. I'm glad I don't have a camera here.
Yeah, that's it's just going to be audio coming from his end. But anyway, hopefully that's cool with everyone. So let's see. I guess as the senior producer, what are some of the things that you do for the game?
Well, I'm the U.S. based senior producer. It's a big team. There's like 300 of us making the game, and it's mainly obviously it's made in Japan. There's a couple of overseas producers like me, myself. There's a guy in Europe, guy in Asia. We all kind of act as regional producers to make sure this game is worldwide, has a worldwide appeal. So what I do is work with my marketing counterparts here to make the game U.S. friendly, I would think. The U.S. market, we listen to a lot of fan opinions. We scope out, go a lot of car hunting in the U.S., seek which cars are popular in the U.S. and which racetracks are popular in the U.S. We ultimately, Kaz, who's the creator of this game, we act as his eyes and ears in the U.S. and give him suggestions on what's trendy in the U.S. and whatnot, you know. And then he will make the final call on which cars and tracks make it into the game, and then there's also all sorts of other things like translating the game and finding U.S. Friendly music soundtracks for the game and stuff like that. But essentially, I'm in charge of overseeing the U.S. The launch of the U.S. version of the game. And actually, I've been doing this for 20 years. I've been working with Kaz since the beginning, 1997.
Very cool.
Yeah.
So, do you have a favorite car that's in this Gran Turismo?
So I have to say the McLarens have always been my favorite.
Okay, well, I have some experience with those, just a little bit.
I hear you have.
Yeah.
You have good taste.
Which one in particular? I don't know how many of the models you have in here.
The 650 is in the game.
Okay.
And that's one of my favorite. But in real life, I do like the original F1 car that came out back in the days. It still looks amazing.
That it does. I actually just saw an article earlier today of one that is basically brand new, 140 miles on the odometer, that's being sold at a dealership in the UK, I think. I can only imagine how much that's going to go for.
I know Mr. Jay Leno has one too.
Yeah, that guy has a lot of cars. He also has a Ford GT, which I'm waiting on one of those. It's a hard process to wait on.
I heard they're picky about the owners on that car, huh?
Yeah, I got lucky there. Yeah, I'm looking forward. Hopefully it'll be soon that new things will happen there. Let's see, any new features that you're excited for in this one?
Well, so I'm going to speak on behalf of Kaz, the creator of the game. He's ultimately our guy. I can't say more about the I cannot stop talking about the quality of the game. It's our first PlayStation 4 Gran Turismo. And it's just a technical masterpiece. You'll notice it right away when you're playing it right now. You see how graphically how beautiful it is. It, when you race it, it runs, you know, it races like butter smooth. It's, you know, if you have a 4K TV, it'll be 4K compatible. If you have a PlayStation Pro, you'll be able to play it in 4K mode, 60 frames per second. It's and the lighting, just the lighting of the lighting technology we have in this game is just, it's like beautiful, and you can probably fool your parents that this is like real life footage.
It's crazy. Like I'll get screenshots from people on Twitter. And it's like, wait a minute, is that like a real card screenshot, or is that on a video game? I can't, it's hard to tell sometimes. And like looking through, because right now we're just playing the intro cinematic, and which is due to technical limitations on my end with audio sync with my capture card not being able to play and talk on Skype and be synced up. But in any case, just I assume that these are all in-engine scenes. And it is very realistic looking.
Cause, the creator of the game, he always wanted to, I think his childhood dream was to become a movie director. And he still takes photos by him. Like some of his photos are in the escapes mode of the game. He himself has a really good eye on things. That's why the game, that's what it makes the game so beautiful.
Yeah, it's makes me want to, you know, jump in and drive some stuff. And then I'm sure afterwards I'll want to actually go driving in real life. So let's see, another question. I know that you guys are aiming for some VR use with this game, which is something I personally have some motion sickness issues, so I wasn't able to do it for an extended period on this stream, but as far as like feeling like you're actually in the car, how's that? Because I assume you've tried it out.
Yeah, I will have to admit, I'm like you. I'm like, I don't do well in general. I'm talking about my personal. I don't do well with VR games in general. But I'd like to hear your opinion once you play VR in this game, because they spent a lot of effort. Obviously, like I said, they're a Japan-based team. And I don't know. I know more Asians get nauseous playing VR, so they're very careful about people not making, you know, making sure people don't get bad experience with VR. So they spend a lot of time, working on that aspect. And yeah. Here we have. So that's why there's only a selected amount of, it's a dedicated mode within the game. So it's not like the game turns into VR all of a sudden. It's a separate VR area where we pick certain. You're not racing against a bunch of cars or anything like that. But
okay,
make sure we don't sacrifice quality. But you're having an enjoyable experience within VR. And I played it. It's fun. Like if you're in like a convertible car, you can look around.
Right.
You can obviously when you're racing. Or you're driving, you want to see your surroundings, you know, I've always wanted like screens surrounding me, like multiple TVs around me. That would be like my most realistic racing experience. But now with the VR, you feel like you have a screen wrapped around your head.
Yeah, that's something I've always thought about before is like taking one of those hydraulic simulator rigs that one day I really want to have one of those, but you need to dedicate a room for it. But then really the next level for that is just doing it with VR rather than having like the three wraparound screens in front of you. And I feel like if you have that hydraulic rig, so you actually are feeling some G-forces, that can help out with any potential motion sickness. Because for me, what happens is when you have movement in the game that's detached from acceleration forces you're feeling in real life, that's what causes it. So having that all integrated together, I want to try it. It'd be wild.
and then you need the smell of a burning rubber.
Right? Yeah, we'll have a bunch of chemical vials next to the thing that combine in order to make all these different smells and stuff, so it really feels like you're in it. And then you just have to have the real cockpit set up as part of your rig with the gear shift and all that, because I feel like you would reach for stuff on your dash and whatnot that's not actually there in real life. Just you're like trying to feel the leather on the dash, but you're like, wait, oh, I'm not actually in this, hold on.
Right. Actually, so the VR is great when you want to check out your car's interior. We've had this game at events with the VR setup. I had people just spending time looking around, like looking down, checking out the stitches on the leather of the car, like looking into the gauges. So you see a lot of people spending more time doing other things than just racing.
Yeah, yeah. I bet you'll have people who, they're like looking to buy a particular car model. They're like, you know, let me just load it up in VR in Gran Turismo. I'll take a look around, make sure the interior is up to standards. Use it as a shopping tool.
Yeah, I think that's some car dealerships and car companies are looking into that. It's becoming like a trendy thing amongst car sales.
No, I read an article recently about a company that's making tech for manufacturers to be able to have people just view the car they're speccing out in a VR headset, so you can get up close with everything before you actually order it, which would be admittedly very, very helpful.
I know somebody like that too. Maybe we're talking about the same company.
Oh, maybe. So let's see. Racing simulators in general, they can be, being as realistic as they are, kind of difficult to get up to that skill curve. So is there like anything in particular that you put in here in order to try to make it accessible when people are just jumping on in the beginning?
Yeah, so, you know, we're not like a PC game. We are a PlayStation game, and we know PlayStation is a very family-friendly console. And this game has always paid attention to be as realistic as possible, but beautiful and also enjoyable. And then in this game in particular, if you start off the game right now, I think it's not working in your version, but once you're online, you'll be able to access the campaign mode. And the campaign mode kind of takes you through the first, second, three, third steps of driving. Uh-huh. So it'll start you off with like, let's accelerate and stop. You know, it's almost like a DMV driving school.
Mm-hmm.
So it's made so that it's kids can play it and elder people can play it. We tried to make this game the game for everybody. We say 7 to 77 and on one of our marketing spiels.
Well, what if you're 78? Is that too far gone then? So you can't be 78?
It's just, I guess... I don't know why. Maybe it just looks cool. 777.
No, I gotcha. Lucky numbers. But then you can go so far as to, you know, go on the full-on simulator rig, turn off all assists, and basically be like driving a real car.
This game is called GT Sport because the pinnacle of this game, the pinnacle feature of this game, is to literally do well on the online races and even become a real-life race drivers. We our game, Gran Turismo, has in the past gave birth to some real-life race car drivers.
Has it really? Okay.
Believe it or not, we had this program. It's almost like in our fifth year in the U.S., more in the U.K., but we teamed up with Nissan, and we did this GT Academy program where we picked the best gamers amongst our fans, and then we have a reality TV program of them going through like boot camp and stuff.
Huh.
And then the ultimate winner gets sponsored by, they get a seat in a race car. So,
that's wild.
And some of our what do you call the graduates? They're actually racing in Le Mans and Japan JGTC races, and we kind of use them as our spokesperson for our marketing ads now.
Yeah, that's actually something that I wondered is like if you have the full on hydraulic simulator set up. As tricked out as it can go, and you play a racing simulator game in there and you get really good, how much that translates into actual driving skill? Because really, I mean, if the simulation is extremely accurate, the only thing that you're missing is some of the G-forces associated with the real driving, but it should behave pretty similarly.
I have met, we've been to a lot of these contests where we judge the competitors, but all those guys who are willing to become a race car driver through our game, they come, they all must always have the steering wheel at home, at least. Mm-hmm. A steering wheel, and then they wear gloves while they play the game. They're pretty crazy.
All right, you gotta get your gloves on to play video games. It's pretty serious stuff. All right, well, you know what, I think we have a lot of people who are requesting some actual gameplay, which I should tell everyone. We're going to play. Don't worry. The servers are down for campaign and multiplayer and stuff, but we got arcade mode, so I am going to be playing that. So I think we might jump on in. But Taku, thanks so much for joining us. And hopefully cheers to a successful launch. I'm sure you got a lot of work to tend to right now.
Yep. We're about to go live tonight.
All right. Well, I hope it goes smoothly, and I'm going to play. I'm looking forward to it.
Enjoy.
All right. Have a good one. Thanks again. All right, guys. I know you've been wanting to see some gameplay. I have a technical limitation on my end where I can't keep myself in sync with the gameplay and a Skype, because Skype is happening without delay, and the stream is happening with delay, and I can't do them both at the same time, so that's why I couldn't play simultaneously. But we should be good now. I have to change the setting to sync myself with the console, is all. So I'm hoping I can do that while we're still live real quickly. Let's change you to that. Apply. Okay, I should be out of sync with my webcam now. That is normal. Everything is fine. And then I just have to change my webcam to this. And now I should be in sync with my audio. Let me know if everything is working properly. And we will exit out of the cinematics here real quick. All right, let's jump on into things. And we will actually play. So let's check that we are in sync here before we start, because sometimes my capture card can get a little out of whack. Looks like we're good. All right, brilliant. So let me know, are we, we're all good? Everything is in sync, fantastic, good to know. So like I was saying, all this stuff is grayed out just because we are not live with the servers because the game's not out, but arcade mode is open. So we're gonna do some, I guess we can go through a bunch of different things here and try them out and see what's up. But this is actually a two-day extravaganza. So we're playing until for another approximately hour and 40 minutes or so here. And then tomorrow, same time, same place, we're going to be playing again. And all the other features, campaign, sport, multiplayer, should be open. So, the two-day stream extravaganza. And let me, hold on, I just got someone checking in with me. And yeah, all right, let's play it up. I tested on Northern Isle Speedway yesterday. It's a pretty basic loop, so let's try to do something that's a bit more of a wild ride here. Maybe with some turns and stuff. How about Brands Hatch Grand Prix Circuit? Oh, I have to unlock things. Okay, so never mind. I guess we're sticking up here for the time being. Hopefully it'll allow me to unlock. There we go, we got some turns and stuff. What time should, 10 o'clock, fine weather? Sure, sounds good to me. Now the only thing here is I don't think I'm gonna be able to do manual control, and that's my own limitation, because I don't have the triggers here, and so I would have to use X and O in order to shift, and I don't know if I'm gonna get my brain around that real good. I might try it later on, but for now we're gonna go auto. Let's choose, what car do we want to choose though? Ooh, we can go with the AMG GT GT3. That sounds pretty good to me. Sounds pretty good to me. Why don't we do that one? And we'll see how it goes. But I will turn off the assists and stuff, because I know you want to you want to see some real racing here. Okay, so we're gonna, I know, automatic, manual. I gotta go auto for now. All right, I gotta go auto. Don't be upset, okay? And we'll go intermediate on the AI just for now, because I'm not an expert yet. This is our first go on the thing other than my little test that I did before. Okay? So, yeah. But see, okay, hey, I'll tell you what. If I was on a wheel here, if I was on a wheel, which I should, would be cool to get, dude. One of these days I am going to get, at the very least, the chair and wheel setup. The full-on simulator rig might be a little bit further away, but at the very least, one day I will get the chair and wheel setup. And in which case, I would definitely do some manual. But for now, because it's like, it's an XO shift, it's because I'm used to this. I'm used to this, all right? I do this. In real life, now actually with all my cars, I do this. I used to, you know, with the Fiat, actually, for those of you who don't follow me on Twitter, I don't actually have the Fiat anymore. I'll be doing a video on it soon. But anyway, so here's what we got. We'll do expert, which turns off because, let's see, these settings can be changed anytime. I would like to have the driving line. That'd be ideal. But all the other stuff I can have turned off. Maybe I'll go into driving options and see. Anyway, but yeah. Okay, let's see. Left stick is good. That's obviously what we want. And then we can also do, yeah, we'll just do R2, L2. Pretty basic. Unless, let me see, could I customize this? Because, no, I guess we're good. It's just telling me. All right, anyway, so as I was saying, yeah, I don't have the Fiat anymore. I may have upgraded slightly. I still wanted to have something that was very, I don't like to complain about things, but I had some ongoing, just, I got flat tires all the time in the Fiat. I think it's because the wheels are so small. And it was just construction all over, but it was mainly because the wheels are so small. I didn't get flats and anything else. And anyway, I ended up, and there were some other things. Like I said, don't like to complain, which is why I didn't vocalize. But I got a new thing that's it's more exciting, but still compact and a daily. So, anywho, hold on, race settings. Should we just start? Let me see, car settings, drive it. Let's see the driving options. Can I get more granular? Oh, okay, here we go. Let's go driving line assist. No, we'll just do braking indicator on. We'll do that and we'll see how we do. All right, let's start the race. So yeah, I got a C63S, which is the second. Oh god. Okay, you want me to brake? Hold up, we're just jumping into things here. And I forgot, oh shoot, which button is the change camera mode. Hold on. Options. Oh god, I didn't mean to exit. I'm so sorry. I really didn't mean to exit. I meant to change camera. Hold on. I just want to see. How do I change? I know it just told me how to change my camera view, and I just completely forgot it. Well, anyway, let's start the race again. I'll just press buttons. Oh, it's R1. Thank you, guys. I overshot. R1. Okay, there we go. That's what we wanted. All right, we're off. Here we go. I know I'm going in automatic, but it'll be cool. Now, I will say that in the, okay, we're supposed to take that at full speed. There was no braking indicator, I realized. All right. We're going. The braking indicator is on the bottom, so we gotta just pay attention for that. I'll try driving line next time, and we'll see how it goes. But in the test race that I did, oh boy, the AI was actually kind of, was pretty difficult at intermediate. Granted, it was just around a loop, and I was kind of testing things out, getting the hang of it, but still. No, don't you do that. Don't you do that. So far, so good. I feel like we're holding up nicely, and what place am I in? 8. Never mind. Not really holding up all that nicely. I could stand to gain some ground here. But it's a pretty sweet car, though. Oh, God. I messed up. I took out the Ferrari. Oh, no. Don't crash into me. We're good. No! No! You seriously? I was trying to get back in the thing, and you just flipped me against the wall. Oh my gosh. I can't believe that you've done this. I can't believe you've done... No, get out of my way. We have ground to regain here, okay? Out of my way. Oh, there's a Toyota FT1? Dude, I hope that the Supra looks like those so badly. Have you guys seen the Toyota FT1? That thing is so sick, and it's like, it just looks too good to be true that it would ever actually be a real thing, because it looks so amazing. But if the new Supra actually looks like that, oh my gosh, I don't know, that'd be like a tempting thing. Oh, I don't need to brake there. I need to memorize the course a little bit more. But again, first time for everything. All right, here we go. Oh God, I've messed up. Oh, thank you for the reset. I appreciate that. Now I'm in 13th place again. Out of my way. I'm so sorry, guys. All right, here we go. All right, we got that hairpin. Out of my way. Okay, here we go, boys. Now we're catching up. Not really again. We're in 10th place. Hey, you know what? It's my first race. First race on a new game. Things are bound to take a little bit of getting used to. I do wish that I had a wheel setup. It would be fantastic. Nope. Don't fishtail me. Don't do it. Out of my way, Mr. Subaru. We got a first place to go. Oh, this is our... we only have 2 laps here. Okay. I'm not sure if we're going to do much in the way of catching up, but we'll find out. All right. Nope, we're not overshooting this corner, though. Brilliant. We got it. And you, my friend, need to get out of my way. Thank you very much. 6th place. Hey, that's the highest we've been so far. All right. Let's hit this nice and quick. All right. There we go. Brilliant. Oh, yeah. I like those corners right there. Come on. Let me get another place. Come on. Out of my way. Oh, shoot. Oh, boy. Oh. That's what I'm... Okay, keep it steady. Podium position after just forcefully shoving cars out of my way. Did I get it? Did I actually get 3rd place? Yeah. I got 3rd place. It was, it was a little rough, but we made it work. I might have made some illegal race maneuvers. My nose is itching a little bit as a result of those illegal racing maneuvers that I've just pulled. But not bad. Not bad at all. I'm sure that in online I would get absolutely destroyed. But that's not even something we have to worry about today, because online is not up yet. So like I said, game is out tomorrow. So the online servers and stuff not out, which is why we're playing arcade mode. But tomorrow, okay, let's do something else, I suppose. Okay, how about let's do some different race things. Yes, what shall we do? Good to go there. Let's do a new track, I suppose. Or time trial, drift trial, custom race. Yeah, let's do another single race. We can switch things up afterwards. For anyone who's just joining, we are playing Gran Turismo Sport, which is a new Gran Turismo game. Again, comes out tomorrow. This is my first time on it. So, takes a little bit of getting used to. Ooh, we could do some off-road if we wanted to. Let's see. Oh, we're almost at level 2, which will unlock a bunch of other things here. So why don't we try Dragon Trail Seaside 2 at a different time of day in the evening with a different vehicle? How about we'll do the Alpha 4C Launch Edition? Dude, the Alpha 4Cs are like pretty sweet, honestly. I am super down with them. Be tough to have as a daily, given that it's a 2-seater and all that. Or we can go white. I'm going to go with red. And again, we're going auto for now. We'll go with the intermediate until I start getting first place every single time. And then we'll up things a little bit. I've seen a couple 8Cs driving around in my life. I guess that's what you get for LA. But yeah, these look really nice too. And price-wise, they're kind of a bargain for what you get. I don't know too much on the reliability side of them, but man, are they some pretty looking things. Also, the Julia is kind of a looker. What is it? The Julia Quadrifuga Fogligio. That's something like that. The Quadrifuglio. It's like the M3 slash, well, C63 competitor, kind of. All right, well, let's, I guess here. Let's do driving options. I'm going to do the driving line. Let's see, should we do any? We could turn off TC if we wanted to. Let's check out what all of our stuff is here. Ooh, we could go into advanced settings. No, I guess we're good there. Let's just change the driving line to on for now. We'll just see how that goes. Everything else is still how it was with the advanced driving mode. I know we can get even more advanced if we want to, but yep. All right, let's start it up. Guys, I swear, if I go manual, it's gonna be bad news. It really is, because it's just gonna be bad news, because there's no way I'm gonna have the muscle memory to do X and O shifts, for now at least. I need a wheel. All right, we're racing cars more in line with the class of the. Oh, you're telling me to brake? Yes. Oh, that the brakes on this one are not quite as good. Is the GT3 car. What do you know? What a surprise. Okay, I gotta be on the lookout for that this time. Let's try it. Okay, so we know that's a pretty big hairpin right there. Eighth place, though. We didn't lose too much ground on that one. Yeah, what up? We passing you. Okay, I think we're gonna be doing some braking here. Oh! Braking feels like quite a chore in this car as opposed to the GT3. Yeah, there's not quite as much stopping power on this one. Well, that's okay. All right, get out of my way. Is that TTRS or TTS? Oh boy. Yeah, this is taking a little bit more getting used to, but that's cool. All right, nope. Out of my way. All right. So, hey, you know what? Even with my not having the best braking lines, we're in first place. This is pretty cool. All right, let's see. No braking. No brake. We don't need to brake here. Braking is overrated. Ain't nobody need to brake. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about right there. We're still keeping it together. Hit those apexes. Mm-hmm. All right, I gotta watch out. There's a very, very strong hairpin. Watch for the brake. Oh, that was too early. Now it's too late. Oh God, I'm off. I'm off, but we're still good. No one's gonna catch up because I was acing those turns. They're right on my tail though. Okay, here we go. Don't you dare pass me. Mm-mm. Don't you dare. All right, and get ready for, get ready for the break. Ooh, Jesus, not good. I'm going off too much. All right. Hey, I'm still in first place, though. It's a good thing we didn't turn that AI quite to the full-on advanced, which I can do afterwards if I want to. I know. If I was playing multiplayer against other people, I'm sure I would be getting my world rocked. I can't even imagine how good people are going to be. Like, people who should actually be professional racers. Why are you telling me to brake there? Why are you telling me to brake there? There we go. Let's accelerate out of that thing. And we're still good. We're still on it. All right. That went a lot better than last time. Not that great, but I guess we have to brake. It doesn't look like that sharp of a turn on the map, which is why I didn't really expect to do it. But, all right. Let's keep it steady. You're ready for the brakes. And through here smooth. Okay. Much better than last time. We're getting to know the course a little bit. Those nice apexes. All right. Yeah, so this last weekend I actually went to the Long Beach. It's called GRC, Global Rallycross. It's Red Bull's thing. Oh God, that's sharper than I thought. Thank you for bouncing me in the right direction, but I think I might lose some time on that one. Hey, you're still in second place. Yeah, I went to the Rallycross in Long Beach. It was pretty cool. It's cool having cars that, you know, it's basically just a shell. Their bodies are. They're not actual. They don't really share anything in common with the street legal production cars, other than kind of looking similar. And then they're like rear engine 600 horsepower in the high classes, which is just ridiculous. And so it's always funny to see those cars that just, they look normal, but also they're more powerful than like the most expensive supercars. So, or not more powerful, but quicker. Oh God, get your turns right, dude. All right, there we go. A little bit better. I don't think we're at too much risk of, failing out of here, but break, and make that. Oh God, I might have gone into a little bit of a too much of a drift there. Oh no! You are gonna need to stay on the track and not lose out. All right, this is too close for comfort. Now, let me just go silent real quick so I don't fail this at the last second. I'd much prefer to win. All right, I think we're safe. Last straight, and we're through. Whew. All right. Yeah, everyone in chat, it's a little bit difficult to race and try to get first place while also simultaneously looking at chat. So, yeah. Anyway. Don't ever use brakes because you're racing and you never have to stop. That seems like a pretty swell idea when you're playing a racing game, for sure. All right, hey, at least we got first place and we got 8,250 credits. How close are we to level 2 and unlocking more tracks? All right, and hey, level 2, we got some more tracks. Sweet. Excuse me. Ugh, still trying a little bit to get over a little cold of mine. It's just, it's lingering a little bit. So, all right, let's do one of these level 2 tracks, and we can try another vehicle. Which one of these level 2 tracks? See, wait, I'm level 2. What are you talking about? Why do you not have, wait, hold on. But I just got the level 2. Why don't you want me to play you? It is not letting me do level 2 trick. I must be missing something, like another criteria that's necessary in order to unlock it. Well, anyway, let me see if we can try one of these other tracks here. All right. Let's see. What shall we do? Let's do, well, we'll do some kind of rally. We could choose like a GT3 car and play it on the dirt course. That would be funny. We'll do evening again. And I like how we can choose from all the, we could choose the Alpha again. We can't choose a Mercedes GT3, but we can choose this puppy right here. Mm-hmm. 521 horsepower at 2,800 pounds for rally. Yes, I think so. Dude, I wonder if you could do the Ford RS200, because that would be sick. The old Group B. Did you know that the Ford RS200, if you go look it up if you haven't seen it, it just looks like a kind of a teeny tiny little thing that you would never expect. You're like, that's kind of a cool looking thing. That's a Ford? Huh, that's interesting. Little bitty guy. All right, but then you, lo and behold, it was around like the late 80s, early 90s, for many years, the fastest, except the homologation version of it, was the fastest accelerating car in the world. This little bitty thing, fastest accelerating car in the world for a production vehicle because of the homologation units. It was like 3.2 seconds to 60, something ridiculous. And you're like, what, that little thing? That little bitty thing, what in the world? Not that I was alive at the time, or even conscious of cars or anything of the sort when I was that young. But, anywho, I guess let's start the game and see how we go here with some dirt. Oh, we were hitting the limiter there and I was like, hold up just a minute. Hold up, did I select, manual? Because that could be a little problematic. All right. We gotta do a little bit of drifting here in this one, don't we? That's kind of the whole point. I've never done anything in the way of like rally racing. I don't actually know, like, so when you're going on an asphalt course, straight line, no drift, no tire spin is the quickest way around the course. Ugh. But in rally, people are always doing slides and stuff, which, like, does that mean, as someone who is less educated in rally, I guess that means that drifting can actually be faster, or is almost like the only way to do things in many cases because of the ground. Okay, come on. Let's go. Get those drifts going, boys! Come on. No. Keep it straight. We gotta do some catch up here. I think we're only against one other vehicle. Yeah. Okay. Dude, he's just going sliding around those corners. And I need to play some serious catch up here. Oh, this is fun. I almost like this more than the asphalt racing. Let's get some driftage. Woo! Yeah, there we go. We're catching up. Also, as soon as I say we're catching up is probably when I'm gonna start failing. But come on. Whoa. Yeah, here we go. Catching up. Oh yeah. Wait, is that a pit lane? Or is that another option? Okay, we messed up, folks. We have messed up just a little bit. I'm so sorry. Now we really have to play catch up. Oh gosh. Alright, come on. Let's get these. I just gotta master the drifts, you know? Oh yeah. Oh, there we go. Cutting some corners. That's how we do it. And who needs racing lines when you can cut corners? Like, or run into the invisible walls. But then 360 style points. He maintains his direction on the track. Wow, impressive. I might have to retry this race though if I get second place, but I think I am doing a little quicker than the first lap. All right, here we go. Oh, man. I'm getting a little bit too excited with my drifting here. Oh, boy. Yeah, we might need to give this one a little redo now that I'm maybe getting a little bit more hang of things, but also not really. I say that as I crash. Oh, boy. I'm not even looking at the chat right now. I'm sure it's not good at all. Forgive me. I'm plus 7 seconds on him. I don't think I'm gonna be doing any catch up anytime soon here. Okay. Feather the throttle. Oh, that's gonna be a problem. Alright, I straight up flipped. It's like I didn't expect to see that view happening anytime in this race, but somehow I've managed to get worse. Okay, here we go. Is he in sight? Nope, he's not. Why are you doing that? See, the thing is, there's a bit in the way of the invisible walls here, and so I think that I'm gonna just go up on the side of the course, but instead it kind of ping-pongs me, and so it's throwing me off slightly, but that's okay. Here we go. And that is not a particularly fantastic, we got some people recommending third person. You want me to do third person? Okay. I like being in the car. It's more simulatory. Is that a word? Simulatory? But I'll try third person if you want me to. As you wish. Okay, let's do it. We'll do a little third person. We're gonna give it a retry here in third person. As you wish. We'll see if this helps me at all. Oh, you just want third person because of the drifts. I see. It also might help me in terms of figuring out how to drift and stuff. It's very possible. But yeah, I get you. I wish I could see those wheels turn, you know, during the drifting maneuvers. Get out of here, dude. Get out of here. Oh, I wanted to fishtail him so badly. Wanted to perform a pit maneuver. Like, I'm the police of this racetrack, sir. You're going to need to stop being ahead of me. You're running away from the police. I'm gonna have to perform a pit maneuver on you. Okay, I'm running into walls here. Don't worry. Okay, give me that drift. I wonder if I should be turning traction control off here. Would that help? I don't know if it like automatically takes care of that for me because we're on a dirt course, or if it's hurting me at all. No, see, like I'm going slightly out of bounds and that's messing me up. Okay, come back here. I feel like I really gotta focus on this one in order to win. Nope, don't run into things. Where, oh gosh, where's he gone to? Come on, keep that, no! Ah, shoot, thought I was gonna be good. Here we go. Oh, that's a drift. There we go. Okay, keep that line steady. We can catch up. We can still catch up. It's still possible. Oh, shoot. I'm going off. Keep it steady. Oh, man. Am I really 6 seconds? So he basically just took off back there. Nope. Stay on course. There we go. That was a smooth drift, right? Hey, there he is. Hey, it's like he goes slower during the first part of the course and then just completely speeds up in the second part. But that's cool. Okay, we got a lock. We got a lock here, folks. Okay, I'm figuring this out a little bit more. I feel like I need to do more braking and turning simultaneously, which is like something you don't want to do when you're on asphalt. You want to brake before your turn. And then you don't want to be on the brake while you're turning, and then you want to accelerate out. Here it's a little bit different, and I feel like that's helping a little bit. We're braking and turning simultaneously, sets me into a little bit more of a drift. And then we can keep up a little bit more. But god dang, dude, he's going real fast on this back area. Okay, you... Shoot. Oh, come on, keep it steady. Oh god, dude. Why are you going so fast? I was doing so well, and all of a sudden, as soon as I get close, you're just like, ah, I'm gonna take off. Please, let me get... What is he, like, do you see this? He's going so fast. All right, there we go. Oh my God, we're gonna do that last minute pass. There we go, that is what I'm talking about right there. First place. Woo! Oh God, I was nervous on that one, but we made it work. That was like that last minute, super gnarly clutch finishing maneuvers right there. All right, still level two. I wonder if, I'm gonna check if we've unlocked those things. All right. Let's see what we got here. So, we beat that one. We're gonna have to up it to advanced AI pretty soon here. Let's see, we unlocked any of the other things. It also might be a situation where because the servers are offline, the servers need to register that I've hit level 2 before it'll actually unlock other tracks for me. So there's a possibility that it won't do it for now, which, yeah. Look at our check marks there. All right. Wait, you didn't register that I got a victory there. Oh, there was that one. Okay, we need to do Lake 2. Lake 2, we'll do some sunrise aesthetic. Be nice. And I think, let's see, what should we do? Mazda, we could do like a Mazda Roadster and see if we could, with the 128 horsepower, see how that goes. Let's try the Miata. Why don't we? Is it not called the Miata anymore? Is it actually just called Mazda Roadster? I didn't actually know that. Okay, you know what? We're going professional, ladies and gentlemen. I feel like I can manage 128 horsepower. There couldn't be that much of a difference between our two cars at that point. I can't be going that fast. Okay. Mazda Roadster in soul red premium metallic. Also, actually, so I've discussed the idea of getting like an old beater in order to learn a real manual transmission and Miata was one of the suggestions there, of getting like a late 90s Miata that has a manual and using that in order to learn. So it might happen at some point. It would make for some good video content, you know? Anywho, let's try off-roading in a Miata. Why not? All right, you guys like that third person when it comes to drifting, I suppose. So here we go. Let's see how this thing handles off-road, huh? Are Miatas are rear wheel, right? Okay, this is behaving a little bit differently than last. It's a little easier to manage, but this dude's, man, we got the professional AI now, so I don't know how well we're gonna. Oh, I didn't even clip that tree there, dude. You can't bounce me off of that when I didn't even click it. What kind of car is this? This feels like a car that we don't get in the United States. I feel like I've not seen this before. But boy, oh boy, is that paint color wild. Oh, that's what I'm talking about! Out of my way, bud! Get out of my way! Yeah! Professional AI, not so professional now! Alright, here we go. Oh yeah, thread those needles. My convertible Miata rally car. Get out of the way. We don't want any spectator crashes here. That's why they canceled Group B. We don't want this to be canceled as well. Okay, here we, oh my gosh, we're just killing the game right now. Got that music just driving me. Oh man, too big. Okay, you want me to brake? Fine, we'll do a little drifted through this corner. All right, here we go. I feel like because the driving line doesn't give you the braking points here, I almost don't necessarily need it. I can almost just like do my own thing when it comes to driving line. And dude, we are gaining some ground on our number two guy here. It's a little bit more difficult to drift on this. I feel like this might actually be front wheel. Oh, I'm glad I didn't go over there because that is pits. Because it was definitely much more of a drifty situation in the last race with our Evo. All right, here we go. Oh my God, just these beautiful turns. The turns, they are just so beautiful. Like, do you see these moves? Do you see how steady we are sticking to that driving line until I inevitably crash on something? Oh, we are 2 seconds ahead. I mean, he's actually like sticking pretty well to our tail, which I don't like. But that's fine. Don't you dare pass. It's probably gaining a little bit of ground. That was not a great turn. Okay, stay on where we need to stay. This was the part where I think I might have over-accelerated, overstretched the limits of my vehicle, but that... Alright. Oh, there we go! What a beauty of a turn right there! I kind of want to be on the inside of the car. That'd be cool, but anyway... Keeping it steady. Oh God, he's been gaining on me. I feel like it's almost like easier to... Nope, no Group B's here. No Group B crashes. I feel like it's almost easier to do well when you're trailing the AI because you can see what the AI is doing and you can kind of prep for that. Whereas now, I'm just on my own. But still, you know, a little bit of first place, first try. A little bit of first place, first... Oh wait, three laps. Oh, I didn't see that part of things. Whoopsie daisies. Okay. No. That's not good. That's not the good thing. That's not the good thing at all. I just choked there. I really did. Because I was like, oh, hey, what do you know? We should have won. And then I was not prepared mentally for a third lap. That's not good. Okay. We just got to maintain our lead this time. Oh, there we go. That was a turn, though. That was a turn and a half. I'm sure I gained some ground on that one. Alright, here we go. Let's just keep it nice and steady. This thing is a lot easier to control than the Evo, I'll give it that. Alright, here we go. Just keep it nice and good. Boom! Threading those needles. Not that it's really a needle that needs to be threaded here. But yeah, there we go, boys. I gotta really focus because it's still kind of, he's not too far on my tail anymore. Keep it up. No catching up. Don't you dare. Actually, I'm 2.8 seconds, which is the biggest lead I've had so far. So this I have really actually been acing this lap. Woo, yeah. But I don't want to mess things up. There we go. Oh boy, we're getting sideways, buddy. Woo. I saved that though. This car is actually a lot easier to keep on track than the Evo. Like, dude, professional AI with the Evo, I don't even know about that one. All right, here we go. And just one more turn, and then we got the sealed. I really have to screw up right now in order to lose, and I'm not gonna do that. Whew! Wait, final... What are you talking about? That was three laps. What is this? This is lap four. Do you not know how to count? Am I out of my mind? That was... That was three laps. What are you doing? What have you done to me? Are you here to force me to do a fourth lap? What? Am I crazy? That was the finish there. Oh, that wasn't the finish line. Hey, I'm smart. Dude, I got 5 seconds quicker on that last lap. I killed it. Woo! Okay, 13,000 credits on that one. There we go, level three. Except again, because we don't have the servers, I don't think it's unlocking things for the time being. But that's okay, because I could try those other courses. Well, we can try another mode. I don't know if that'll unlock. Race by yourself against the clock. Drift trial. Put your drifting skills to the test. Ooh, what do we have here? Which one? How would we... Okay, it looks like we are... So it looks like we got these ones. You know, actually, before we go into drift trial, which I don't know if that... I don't know if drift trial is grading you based on like style points, style and speed, but what I could do is let's try the loopy one and see how we can do. Let's try nighttime on the loop. And which car should we do? Well, we haven't done the RCF. Why don't we try this one? Let's see if we can win on the loop against some professional AI. Here we go. Here we go, folks. All right. Again, I was having a little difficulty. This was what I did my test on yesterday when I was just setting things up. And it was kind of difficult just doing the oval. So maybe I've improved since then, though. I've gotten used to things a little bit. Mm-hmm. So tomorrow, though, we'll be able to, we should be able to unlock more tracks, we'll be able to unlock more cars. It might reset my experience and stuff, because I think that's usually what they do for people who had the game before launch, so that they don't have an unfair advantage. It's probably gonna reset my stuff. But still, then we'll actually be able to make a little bit of progression once things are all good. So, anywho, let us start the race. See, and we can actually, you know what? I'm gonna go in cockpit, because we're not trying to drift anymore. Wait, we have a Veyron here? I'm in a Lexus, and we're racing against a Veyron. Okay, here we go. Yeah, see, it's kind of hard to get the line right here. Okay, and man, the professional AI, like, you're telling me to brake on this? Dude, don't pass me. No. Get out. Oh, God. That's not good. No. Stop hitting me. Stop it. Oh, geez. I'm in the wall. Position 20 out of 20. I'm going to get lapped. Yeah, dude. I was saying, like, the oval is actually kind of difficult. Oh, boy. If I get lapped, it's going to be really embarrassing, actually. Yeah, but what do you mean? I'm in a Lexus, and I'm driving up against Veyrons. Are you kidding? Please don't lap me, though. Please don't lap me. I know that you're not really supposed to drive on the flat bottom, but don't mind me. That's just what I do. Okay. All right. How many laps? 15 laps. I feel like I might be able to catch up if I just don't suck. Here we go. You'll have to pardon me. Can't read chat because we're experiencing a heck of a comeback here. Oh, I can see cars. That's really good. That's an improvement. That's a big improvement that there are cars ahead of me. Okay. Please catch up to them. As someone who likes cars, getting last place is not really my ideal thing. I feel like it's a matter of personal pride that I can't get last place. But I'm getting the hang of things more. I'm getting the hang of the throttle control on this one. Full acceleration out. I'm not braking anymore. We're just lifting off the throttle a little bit as we go in. It's a banked corner. And then we accelerate on the way out. Yeah, that was a corner. That gained a little bit of ground. Lift off the throttle, loose on the throttle. When I was at the Lambo thing the other week, that was the first time I'd ever done anything banked. Okay, you're gonna need to not do that. I know you don't want to be last place either, but sometimes life comes at you fast. Okay? No, not today. No, not today, Mr. GTR. I'm gonna pit maneuver you. This is the police. This is the sound of the police. No, don't put me into the wall again, you son of a... I'm gonna get lapped because this dude just decided he wanted to put me into the wall. That's an illegal maneuver. He just put the police into the wall. Like, you can't do that. You cannot do that. I cannot believe that this has happened. I am almost being... Hey guys, I'm in first place here, actually. Pretty cool. Dude, these guys behind me, they can't even catch up. They can't even hang. They're trying their best to catch up, but I'm gonna start gaining tons of ground on them. Like, look at this. They have no chance, dude. No chance. First place. Games just, they can't calculate. It's like 20? Nah. I've gone so fast that I warped into another dimension where it... Like, I changed the rate of time passing. And now time is passing slower for me than it is for everything else, and I'm just winning. So... That's what's happening. That's scientifically accurate. But see, I am gaining over the other dudes. I'm gonna not do the oval next time. Because this is not my best work, I do admit. At least they're not catching up on me. Because just to think, if I didn't get sent into the wall by that dude, like, rookie in the racing season as well, then I would be in first place by now. I would. I lost 15 seconds on that. Absolutely. 15 seconds he got me for. Okay, lap 14. It's going to say that they finished first in just a moment, but really they did not. That's not what happened. See, final lap, and I'm in the lead. And it's pretty great. I've been doing pretty well this race. Being able to hold that first place position for so long is quite an accomplishment. And there we are.
Woo! First place. Yeah.
All in a day's work for your boy. The best racing driver on the circuit. Pretty professional maneuvers, if you ask me. You say he cries and moans about an AI crashing him after he rudely passes everyone. Do the AI have feelings? Do the AI have feelings for you? Because I feel like your sympathy for the AI is a bit too strong. Okay? But maybe, you know what, in the future when robots take over, you know what, having sympathy for AI might actually get you pretty far in the world, so don't listen to me. Okay. So let's do, what should we try? We race against ourselves, except I don't know what like an ideal time is. Man, if we could play the Le Mans track, I actually know what a good time is on that, and that'd be sick. The LMP1 cars get 315s, which is gnarly. I was getting like a 350 when I was playing on the simulator rig at the Peterson. And, yeah. But anywho, man, I want to play with the Chiron. Maybe we'll have that unlocked tomorrow. We'll see. Might be able to get some hookups. But anywho, let's try racing one of the other tracks. Actually, we didn't do this one, did we? Let's do you in the we'll do morning, and we are going to go professional. We'll do professional. In what car should we do? Something new. How about the M4 Coupe? In what color? We will do Yas Marina Blue. Oh, dude, I didn't even need to read that it was Yas Marina Blue. I knew that was Yas Marina Blue. I know what my colors are. Actually, Yas Marina Blue is like the only BMW color I know, and it's specific to the M4, I think. All right, professional. Here we go. Let's do it. Let's do it, boys. Aim for clean passes or ramming is a bit of advice. Don't do anything in the middle where you just kind of sideswipe things. Either do a clean or just ram the heck out of everyone. Like, just go all the way. But don't do any intermediate stuff. Uh-uh. Hey, you say that's your car? Nice! You got an M4? That's pretty sick, dude. That's pretty sick. Oh, okay, I'm gonna be honest with you real quick here. Obviously, C63 and, well, you got C63 coupe and sedan versus M3, M4. They're kind of like the direct competitors, more or less. I had an AMG in the past. I liked it. It was good. They had some transmission problems, I'll admit, which they did on the last engine that they used. There was transmission problems. It was CLS 63. That was the first like nice car that I had bought. I bought it new, and I was explaining this before we get into the race, because otherwise there's no way I'm going to be able to focus on storytelling while racing against the professional AI. But in any case, dude, like I would drive it in manual mode, and there would be instances where I'd like go for a downshift, and they'd be like, "Huh? You want a downshift? Nah, that's not gonna happen." I'd be like, "Wait, did it not register that I shifted down?" And then I'd hit it again, and it'd be like, "Oh, what's that? You want two gears simultaneously? Clunk!" And it'd make a really bad noise, and I was like, "Okay, we're not driving in manual mode anymore. Not gonna do that. I don't want to break my car. Jesus Christ, that's not what's supposed to happen." So anyway, but now with the current generation of AMGs, they appear to have fixed that problem. I drove the C63S Coupe back in January at the Michelin event that I went to. I made a vlog on that. Yeah, it was way better. It was way better, like much, much super duper improved. And because of that, I was like, I'm impressed by this. And then that's why I went for it over like M3, M4. I know everyone has their preference. Big M car fans, big AMG car fans. I tend to significantly prefer Mercedes interiors to BMW. I think Mercedes is like as top notch as it gets when it comes to their interiors. Have you seen the interiors on like the S-Class, the S63, the Maybach, the S65? Oh my God, their interiors are beautiful. It's like, it doesn't get better than that. You look at, Rolls-Royce is known as the pinnacle for luxury cars. I think Mercedes interiors are so much nicer, even than Rolls-Royce. Like, it's gnarly. But any hoosers, let's start the race. People are requesting third person, but I like first person. It's just, it feels more real. All right, maybe I'm gonna do first person for this race, but yeah. All right, here we go. All right, and the brake. Yo, I'm in an M4 and we're racing against 458s and racing against 12 Cs here? What? This is not an even playing field. Are you kidding? They're on professional AI? How are you gonna tell me this is an even playing field, boys? All right, 458, I love you. Come back here. I just wanna get better views of what you look like. But really though, how, oh geez. Oh, why am I, was that? No, don't do that. Okay, we're going for that Ramaroo pass. Get out of here. Oh God, I just hit him in the tail. I'm gonna ram him. I'm gonna go for that pit maneuver didn't work. Also, we got the AMG, or the SLS AMG. which is actually the SLS AMG probably isn't much quicker than the M4 because that's more of like a GT cruiser. No! What are you doing? This has not gone well. And there's an NSX here? It's behind me? How's an NSX gonna be behind me? That thing's way quicker. Yo, this handling is, oh, dude, this has the HUD in it? Yo, my C63 has the HUD? It's so cool. I've never had a car that has HUD before. It's awesome. Like, I can just be looking at the road, and it's like, this is your tack, and this is what gear you're in, and also your speed, and I'm like, this is amazing. I love this. Dude, if you have an option for a HUD, get that. It's so nice to be able to look at the road and also see your tack simultaneously. It's so sick. Anyway, that's just me on... I know HUDs aren't even like a... They're not even like a new thing. But, dude, it's cool. Anywho, here we go. All right. And we are off. Okay, at least we're back in 10th place, which is good. NSX, I know you're... In real life, you're quicker than me, but you need to stand back. All right, here we go. Oh, that was a good corner. That was a good corner right there. Okay, Mr. 458. I love you very much, but you're going to need to get paced. Thank you. All right, here we go. What do we got up here? Wait, what even is that? Is that a Nissan up there? Hold on just a moment. Are these some, like, GT3 cars that we have? Because that is not... What are you? What is this? Oh, it's a Citroen. Okay. Oh, that's one of that, like, fancy Citroen. Those are not in the U.S. Are those even in Europe? That thing's pretty sweet. I've seen it before on, like, video, but I don't know if it's a... Oh, God, I needed to brake more. Okay, don't know. No. Wait, oh, go reorient me. Oh, God. I messed up so tremendously. I'm so sorry. Also, 12C, how are you doing so poorly? You're the fastest car of, like, anything here around the track. Oh, I can't believe I did that. I cannot believe I have done this. All right, I really... No, this again, this corner screws me up every time. We're going to restart. We're gonna have to do a little redo on this race here, folks. Hey, it's another M4. At least I'm ahead of that one for a little while. Dang it. I'm so sorry. I've failed everyone. Now we're passing on the inside here. Just keep your traction and keep your line. Thank you so much. At least I can... Let me regain a few spots. Oh my god, I'm 25 seconds off the leader. Are you kidding? Okay, and get ready for the break. You've been passed. I might actually be... What are you doing? What is that? What was that? What did you do to... No! Okay, that's unacceptable. I hit air, and it was like, you're wrecked. No. Oh my gosh. Dude, I need to do, like, the AMG GT3 because this M4 is killing me. What is going on? What is going on with this M3? I feel like I was not having these issues with the GT3 car. Oh gosh. Unless I have the lap of a lifetime on the next lap, things have not gone well. Okay, here we go. Let's just ram and pass you. No, not this again! Oh, boy. Woo! Oh, this is not my proudest work. Hey, we've gotten first place a couple times here, so you can't win them all, right? Maybe I should just restart with another car. Or should I go for... I'll just go for the final. I'll just stick with it. I'm just going to stick it out. What can I say? All right, here we go. And remember that this is a very sharp corner, because I seem to have a hard time remembering that. No. Don't you dare spin me. My God, we're good. Woo! That's the first time I actually did that corner. Sometimes slow is fast. Okay. And this corner too, for some reason, I just can't seem to get properly. And this, or is it this one? I don't know, whichever. I think it was the one that I just hit actually. Okay. Out of my way. I have places to be, people to see, people who are counting on me. Nobody's counting on you guys, you're AI, okay? They're counting on you to fail. Okay, dude, here we go. We're gonna get back to 10th place real good here, I hope. Or at least pass the other M4. I've gotta be the front M4. Okay, come back here. Yeah, there we go. Okay, we're breaking. Look at that little air brake on the 12C. Beautiful. Okay, don't hit the air that you hit last time, because that would be bad. Oh, that's what I'm talking about. Beautiful corners. And you're gonna get passed. Yes! Okay, I feel like I'm getting the hang of things a little bit more, and I might be able to. I'm gonna try the M4 again in the next race, and I'm gonna do well. I'm gonna do a little bit better than 10th place, I promise. Alright, slow is fast. I just gotta kinda remember that. The question is, can I pass you before we hit the finish line? Come on! Give me ninth, get out of my way. Ninth place, woo! Ninth is first. That's what they say, right? Ninth is the new first. I've heard that before. I've heard that as a saying. Ninth is the new, God, he got, wow. First place. Oh, he's in a GT3 RS, that ain't fair. That's not fair. Oh, there's a 650 up there. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that the GT3 RS would actually win out of that playing field. Actually, is it GT3 RS versus 650S? Which wins? Which, I don't actually know which one wins. Well, anyway, let's try that again. And hopefully things will be better next time. Yeah. We're gonna beat the GT3 RS. We are, and it's gonna be great. Here we go, folks. All right, we are gonna stay on the track because slow is fast. Thank you for starting me off in the middle of the pack, though. I very much appreciate it. It would be better if I started off in first place, but that's fine. You know what? You can't always get what you want. But I know that we can do better than last time at the very least. Brake, and we're gonna go hard brakes here, hard brake. Yeah, okay, thank you. Please get out of my way though, I don't want to slide out, and you're making that a possibility. All right, at least we're staying in the game here. I'm kind of just focusing here, or doing my best to, so might be more limited docking this time than last, but also I really embarrassed myself last time and I don't want to do that again if I can possibly avoid it. You know? Here we go. There we go. That's a nice little pass there, and we're keeping it steady. I feel like the corner up here is a good opportunity to get some passing in. How am I 13 seconds behind the leader? How am I 13 seconds? That's not even fair. Okay, we just had some nice catch up, but you need to avoid the wall. Thank you. Woo! I was really close to that spot where I messed up last time. Yeah! Okay, now we're don't you dare pit maneuver me. I am the one who does the pit maneuver. I am the one who knocks. I am the one who does the pit maneuvers.
Okay, alright, get ready.
Oh, here we go. Don't you dare fishtail me out. Dude, that guy all yeeted. First place is the GT3 RS again. And I really have some catching up to do. I'm like 12 seconds behind. Okay, here we go. And a little bit of brake, Keep it steady. Nope. Not you. No. Oh my god, I swear if you knock me out, I'm going to be very upset. Okay, that could have gone a lot worse. We're still in it to win it. Fifth place. Dude is just killing it out in first, though, so I'm like, I don't know how you want me to catch up, but I guess I'll do my best. Oh, there's the Lancer. Okay, we're gonna get a little bit passing in. Is that the 650 up there? I think it is. All right, here we go. Oh, yeah, get past 650. There is no way in the world that an M4 is passing a 650 ever, but I do appreciate you giving it to me here. They are on very different leagues. Okay, we're in third place. Things have great. How is a 4C out in front of a 650? I guess we have a great skill gap in the drivers here. A very significant skill gap. This is like, we got Lewis Hamilton behind the wheel of the 4C, and we have a 10-year-old behind the wheel of the 650. That's the only explanation. Whoa, what are you doing? No, what have you done? What have you done? Oh my god, there was no excuse for that. I'm so sorry. I'm still in fifth place, now it's sixth. Okay, spoke too soon on that one. But there is no excuse. I just drove him into the wall. I did not drive him into the wall. God, my race was going so well so far. Shoot! It's okay. I still have time to play a little bit of catch-up. Probably not, like, first-place catch-up. But a little bit of catch-up. Like, we're not going to be that Heinz catch-up. That number one. Okay. What you need to do is stop that. Okay, we're not going to be that Heinz catch-up, but we might be whatever that second leading brand is in the grocery store. I don't know what it is, but yeah, that. Whew. Don't use the brakes, you say. That tends to be a good idea in racing games, because, yeah, who needs brakes? Accelerate through everything. Okay, out of my way. Clean pass. Clean pass, no Ramsky doodles. If you, there we go, he's back. All right. Okay, there we go. Break. That was not good, not great. That could have gone a lot better, but are we really in second place? First place in the GT3 RS is, oh, he's over there. Don't tell me he's like 12, 13 seconds ahead or I'm not gonna accept that. Okay, we're fine. No. Keep it steady. Ooh, that was a bit of a save. Putting on a lot worse. But at least we're in second place, right? Although some of you might live life by the saying that if you're not first, you're last. Oh my gosh, he's far out there. Yeah, I don't know if that's happening. Okay, that was a good corner. That was good. I think I gained some ground, but this dude is quick. Let's not mess this one up again, huh? How about it? Slow is going to be faster here because we learned that last time. Whew. Only 5 seconds behind, but I don't think I can make it up. Dude, that dude is so far beyond everyone else. Are you kidding me? Come on! Oh, we're so close! There's no way I'm catching him. Not a chance. Ah! I wonder if it weren't for my one mess up there, I might have been able to win. But that dude is quick. Ugh. Dang it. Ah, man. Yeah, dude, if I didn't have that one spin out, I might have had it. You are very right about that. Should I? I don't know if I should try that one again or if we should just switch to another vehicle. I really want to win. What do you guys think? What do you guys think? Should I try it again? Same race, or should I go for something else? Oh, I cannot believe that it was so close. If it weren't for I was 2 seconds off. 2 seconds. Oh man, dude. We're getting a little bit of a. It seems like more people are going for Switch cars. I feel like I'm hearing more Switch cars. All right, so we'll switch cars. We'll try other races in different cars, as you wish. I could try Drift Trial, I suppose. Let's see what Drift Trial is. Why not? And then we'll go back and we'll see if we can conquer something like that at the end. I feel like for Drift Trial, we gotta be on a dirt track and we'll do some nighttime drifting. Gotta get that Tokyo Drift. And of course, we're gonna use the Lancer Evo. But we're gonna go back to that and we're gonna win. By the end of things. 100%. 100%. Bang, 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 feel the killer laid and whiz on past. And yeah, I'll do third person for this. It's a lot easier to see what's going on when you're in third person for drifting. Yeah, I know. I'm drifting in automatic. I can't wrap my head around doing X and O for switching. I can't do it. It has to be something. It has to be that maneuver, okay? And I don't have the setup for this maneuver. We don't have the three pedal and the shift. So yeah. All right. So how is this gonna work? Do we get points for doing sick drifts? Certainly hope so. All right, third person. Here we go. Oh yeah! Okay, that was pretty good. And then here we go. Hoo-yah! Oh, the drift is so strong. That wasn't the strongest drift I've ever had in my life. That could have been better. Oh man. Whoop! That was a good drift right there, dude. Here we go. And through. Oh man, was I. Oh, that's it right there. Okay. We're gonna retry. I feel like I can do a lot better. I guess the ideal is to keep the drift the entire way through, right? Not the greatest. Oh, shoot. Okay, I can do better. I think I just murdered my score by running into the wall there. Okay, hold on. It's not about time though, at least we know that. I'm getting booed by people. Oh god. All right. Yeah. We'll do that again. I can do better. Ay. I need to go maybe a little slower. Let's see. There we go. That was a little bit better. And then. Oh, don't hit the wall! No! That was so good! Shoot! Okay. Oh, I almost had a really solid one there. Try again. Oh my god. You want me to, hold on, I can turn things down a little bit. One sec. I'll turn things down a little bit for you. Okay, that was good. That was fine. This is the one that I just have to get right, though. Oh, come on! No, no! God! Dang it! You're killing me. You're killing me. You're killing me. I know you're booing me, you guys. I'll do better next time. I really need to ace that last section. Okay. Okay, I don't know how I can get more flags on that part, because I'm like drifting the whole way through, so it's like, what else do you want from me? Okay, 3,400. There we go, 11,000, much better. Woo! Sector score, 1, 2, 3. I wanna have something to like compete against though, score-wise. So I don't know, I feel like it'd be easier if there were, and it might be the case once the servers are up, but right now I don't have much of a reference point in that regard, so I am gonna go back to racing against the AI, but I at least did better there. I at least didn't crash. Yeah, that's an improvement. Alright. Let us head out of here. And, oh, someone's saying a good score is 20k. Well, I don't drift. Alright, I race on asphalt. Okay. Let's check out what some of these things are. We got the... Can I? Oh, these probably requires server to be up. So, here we go. I'm going to do. Let's do Seaside 2 in the dark, or dusk, I should say. We're going to use the AMG GT GT3. We'll see how we do with that. And then see if I can win in a professional mode. And then we will go back to whatchamacallit, the M4. On Seaside 1, and see if I can win. And again, for anyone wondering why we are just doing arcade mode, it's because the servers, the game's not out yet, so the server's not online for us to be able to do the other modes. But tomorrow we should have access to just about everything. All right, first place is happening. It's gonna happen. Oh, absolutely. Don't you doubt me for a second. Oh, we want some inside the car action here. That's the way to go. Okay, so we're gonna need to brake here soon. All right, keeping it in the game. I wasn't even paying attention to when it told me to brake there, but I got it good. What was the car that we used last time on this course? This was the Alpha course. This is the course we used for the Alpha. Right. No, and no, do not spin me out of my way. I need to get a bet. Oh, you're gonna put me into the wall? Is that how it is? I don't think so. I do not think that is how we behave here. That is very unbecoming behavior. I'm sorry, Mr. 458, I love you so much, but I really need to get around you. So if you could pull aside, I'd appreciate that. Okay, and do we need to do any brake? No braking. No braking, we just slam other cars into the wall. Yep, that's what we do here, because we are... professional about- Whoa, did you really just do that? You really just did that? How dare you? How dare you do that? Okay, I'm gonna slam you for doing that. Oh god. Oh no, we don't want to be out there. We don't want to be out there. No, we don't. No, we don't. Get back on the track. Oh my god, you did it again! Dude, I'm getting spun by the Ferrari! And I can't go anywhere. Did you just break my engine? What are you doing? I just got spun out by him twice. Hold on. No. Sorry, guys. That's not... I refuse to accept this. All right. You know what? I may like Ferraris, but him, whoever that driver is going down. I'm going to make it my singular mission in life to put him into the wall. I feel like I didn't take that turn as gracefully as I did last time, but I see you, red 458 GT up there. Uh-huh, I see you. And I am coming for you. I am going to annihilate you. If it's the last thing, it might be the last thing I do because I just spun. Okay. That's all right. We can recover. We only lost two places there because of these cars deciding that they just want to put me into the wall left and right. It's like I've just been singled out here and targeted. Not the best corner. I broke a little bit after I needed to there. But that's fine. We can redeem ourselves because I'm faster than all of you. Alright, here we go. Here we go. We're keeping it nice and steady till we get back into the game and annihilate our nemesis. Which, he might not know that we're nemeses, but I do. And that's what matters, is that I know. Nemesis is the plural of nemesis, right? Am I correct in my grammatical use there? You need to come back right now. Alright, this corner. Forgot about that one. It's okay. We're not so great there. Oh my god, everything that can go wrong did go wrong on that one. God, that reminds me of like the Laguna Seca corkscrew or something like that. And it's not helping me. Shoot, back into 13th place. That didn't work. That did not work at all. Let's play a game of catch up again. All right, I think we gained a little bit of ground on that corner. Good. Please come back. It is the last thing I do. I just want to end the Ferrari. I could do time trial. It's just like the thing is, I need a reference, and I don't know if it's gonna give me like a good time to strive for. So. There we go. Okay. Good. Hey, we're back in 12th place. That's an improvement, right? Definitely. Hey, we're gonna pass you here in a moment, Mr. Corvette, if that's cool with you. That would be much appreciated. I see the Ferrari up there. I see him, and I am going to splatter him. Actually, 18 seconds behind. We have come from further behind and done all right. I need to get out of my way. I see you. I'm coming for you. You didn't think you would see me again, did you? No, you did not. All right, we just got to be mindful that we do have the corkscrew here. No! Don't do that. There we go. That's how we do that. And now... Oh boy, I am on my way to get you. No, Aston Martin, get out of my way. I have no beef with you, dude. It's with the guy in front of you, so if you could just let me through, then everything would be fine. No, you need to get out of the way. I need to ram him. I need to ram him, not you. Okay, you're going into the wall. Right now. You're going into the wall. Or not. He just survived that, and I don't like that. I'm gonna brake check you then. All right, here we go. Now we're making some moves. Ooh, I took that a little bit wide, but we're fine. Fourth place. All right, we may be able to give this one a little comeback. Sorry, people were saying that some of the noises were too loud, and so I turned it down a little bit, and now I'm hearing that it's a little bit too quiet, I guess. So, all right, I'll turn it up a little bit after this race. Just give me a moment. Okay, we're getting into podium position here, at least. I just got to make sure that I hit these next few turns nice and smoothly, which I did. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay, still keeping it third. I don't like that he was getting a little bit close on that one. Not at all. I have a moth that is flying around me right now, and it's really distracting me. You need to stop doing that, moth. You're really... Look at the first and second place way up. Go away, moth. Go, where are you? What are you doing? Where is it? Get away, you're distracting. Well, hey, third place. It could be a lot worse. Even though they were like 8 seconds ahead of me. But that's not the end of the world. What is the end of the world is this moth that needs to go away. Where are you? I guess it's gone. Okay. Okay. Here we go. Here we go, guys. We're going back to the M4. And we are going to win on hard mode. Look at that. Wait. Dragon Trail. Oh, because I didn't win. Dragon Trail Seaside is what we were doing. We'll go nice daytime. We're going to go M4. We're going to go Yas Marina Blue once again. And we're going professional. Yes, I know it's automatic. But again, if you're just joining us, we're just... X and O are weird things to use. They're weird things to use. Okay, that is... No! You need to go, Mr. Moth. I'm going to... You need to go away right freaking... I don't want to smash my keyboard. No. Oh my god, he's on the under. I just murdered the moth. Oh god, I just got moth dust on my fingers. He's dead. He's dead, Jim. Hold on, I gotta clean this up. Oh, that's a dead moth. That's a very dead moth. All right, it's dead. It's good. Hold on, I'll turn it up ever so slightly. Ever so slightly. Woo. All right, I feel very accomplished. I've just managed to get rid of a moth. And that means I'm gonna win this race. Here come the moth advocates in the chat, though. How dare you? He was getting in the way of my driving, okay? I know, poor moth. I should have just let him fly in front of my screen. I'm the worst. I'm a ruthless, terrible human. Okay. We're beating the GT3 RS. I assume that's still going to be what's in the lead here. Whoa, stop doing things that you're doing right now. I managed to recover from that pretty nicely. Wow, that was a lot better than I thought it would be. Oh, god, dude, the M4 coming from the GT3. This thing is all over the place. Mother of god. Man, you just don't know how to stay with your traction. Holy crap, I need to get back into the mode on this. Okay, out of my way. I'm all over! Dude, this thing slides like crazy. I guess people do drift in these things, but my goodness. You're all over the place. Try to stay still for a moment, please. Okay, hold it steady, please and thank you. And get back here, Mr. Ferrari. You're not the evil red one that was, you know, I was dealing with last time, but still, gonna need to pass you and I might ram you up here. Why don't you stay still? Stop losing your traction all over the place. God, this thing, it will not stay still. You're still drifting, Jesus. All right, hold it, hold it, hold it. Thank you. Oh boy. Okay, gonna give you a little pass. Just don't mind me. And we're gonna catch up to the cars up here. So far, at least I've not had any like major mishaps yet. Well, I did kind of have a major mishap, but somehow managed to save it. And still, we're good. Eighth place. I really need to make up a lot more time on this second lap. How much? I don't know how far ahead the GT3 RS is, but I think it's pretty far ahead. All right, here we go. Here we go. Out of my way, Mr. Mustang. No, don't. Oh, I'm getting pit maneuvered. But I managed to keep it up. All right. 13 seconds is actually, I think, better than we were last time around. So we might still be in the game, sort of. Making up a little bit of time here. Fifth place. If we can get into like third by the end of this lap, we might have a chance. I don't remember what I was in last time, position-wise. Please. Oh, no, no, no! That's a mishap. That's gonna ruin our chances right there. Oh, my God. I guess I really, really need to try to avoid contact with other cars because it does screw me up tremendously every time. It's like the AI is just like, nah, I'm kind of a tank and don't get affected when you run into me, but you are gonna spin. Okay, here we go. I need to play a little game of catch up here still. God. Okay, okay. I swear, you guys, just get out of my way. Stop trying to physically block me. 13 seconds back, we're gonna make up on this last lap. Okay, here we go. Getting into two. Do not run into my tail. Oh my gosh, 13 seconds back on the number one guy. That's just, look at him up there. Look at him all the way out there on the mini map. That's fine. We're gonna make it work. I feel like I could definitely have done that a little bit quicker, but I think I'm making up some time. Okay, we see him out there. I can do this. I can do this. I even had some mishaps here, and I'm still holding it okay. If you could stop spinning your wheels. We're 8 seconds down. We've made up 5 seconds so far in like the first 40% of the map. Oh shoot, no, keep it going. Oh my god, that could have gone so much worse, but still, this is gonna be hard. Man, they really make the first place guy have to just be so much better than all the rest of the cars. Yeah, dude, if I didn't have that mishap last time, I would probably be okay. Okay, all right, get ready on the brake. We have not got much track left in order to make up for the time here, but let's try to see if we can do it. Man, he just accelerates so quickly off all the turns. I gotta play a risky game here. And it's probably not gonna pay off. Oh, shoot. He's going so quick. Like, I blink and all of a sudden he's increased his distance by 50 car lengths out in front of me. You need to get back! Ah! Oh.
1.5 seconds. So I made up 11.5 seconds on that last lap. God. I gotta do it again. I was 10 seconds out of second place.
Okay. All right. Nope. I gotta do it. Dude, before today's race is over, I gotta do this again. We're doing it again. We are gonna win. If it's the last thing that I do. Oh, if I hadn't done that one bad spin out at the start, in the first lap, I would have been okay. Honestly. Alright, keep it up. Not that was very elegant at all, but it's just the acceleration on the GT3 RS as it is in this particular race is so crazy. Alright, let's see if we can make up some time here. No talking. Very serious. I need to win this race. Please stop sliding. This thing just likes to get so loose. Could have taken that turn a lot nicer. I didn't brake enough going into it, but that's okay. All right, at least we're doing better than we were in this section on the first lap last time. We're 12 seconds back, which I think is again better. So here we go. See if we can make up some time on this turn. Okay, I felt myself getting a little squirrely there and managed to save it, so even though I didn't gain any places, it could have been a lot worse. We can gain on this one, though, for sure. Alright, so our first place dude just went through. How many seconds off are we going to be? I mean, if it's like 13 seconds or so, that's still totally manageable. We're in 7th place. I think we're doing better than we were last time. What is it? 13 seconds off. Yeah, that's kind of what I figured. And break. Okay, let's try going in wide this time, if possible. See if we can get a better line. I think that was better than last lap. Whew. Okay. Doing all right. 13 seconds off still. Which I think is still where we were at, unless he's going even quicker in this race than he was last time, which would be kind of lame. Okay, keep it steady. Okay, so I think this is kind of where we were car-wise last time, because this is where I tried to spin the McLaren, and it didn't really work very well in my favor. This time, that was clean. All right. 10 seconds. We've gained 3 back. We might actually have a chance here. We're going for clean passes now, if possible, because dirty doesn't seem to work quite as well. All right. I love to get squirrely on that one, but still keeping it together. 10 seconds off. 9 seconds. Okay, now we're actually starting to make up some time. Nice and smooth. A little bit of break. Keep it steady. I like it. All right. Woo! I feel like I might see him going around this. I might see him. There we go. Eyes on the prize. No, 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 don't do that. Ooh, I almost lost it there for a second, but we're still good. All right, this is a lot better than where we were last time, I think. Okay, we are how many seconds back? 4 seconds, as opposed to 13 last time. Oh, we're making up that time beautifully. Oh, it's gonna happen. I can feel it. I just have to hold it together. If I drive this lap just the same as I did last lap, we've got it. We got it in the bag. I don't have to do anything different. Hey, buddy, how are you doing? I'm right on your tail. You've been used to winning a lot. I am gonna put a stop to that, all right? Because it's about time that things change around here. It is a pretty car, though. I do enjoy looking at it. But I just need to... No! No! Don't! You're trying to fit... You're trying to play dirty. Mm-mm. We're in first place now. Okay. 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 Hold it together. Do not choke, or I'm going to be so mad. Please? No! He is actually... trying to go for a pass on this. He's hitting me. Oh my god, no! Are you serious? None of the other cars do this. What? What is this? What is this? What is this? Oh my gosh, are you serious right now? Are you serious? He literally just turned his driving level up. Because I passed him! What is going on? Are you serious? No. No. No, 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 no! What? What is this? Dude just got better at driving because I... The dude just got better at driving. Did you see that? Did you see? 6 minutes and 52 seconds. Last round? Last round, I got a 7.06. And that was... He got a 7.04. Dude got a 7.04 last time. He just improved his time by 12 seconds. Because I did better. What? Y'all are mad about the suggested line, but you're not focusing on the fact that he just raced 12 seconds faster than last time. Holy crap. Oh my god. And I got a clean race bonus too. Oh my gosh. I didn't realize that it scaled. Holy crap. Dude just decided to turn on the heat. Holy crap. Yeah, dude, he was sandbagging for sure. Oh my goodness. Well, okay. You know what? We have tomorrow, folks. We have tomorrow to redeem ourselves. For the time being, though, we have hit the end of our broadcast. Man, I gotta redeem myself tomorrow. And yeah, you guys are saying that there's rubber banding in the sense that they do get faster as you pass them. So, all right. Yeah, also, I mean, it totally makes sense that a GT3 RS would beat an M4, no problem at all. Like, I get that based on stats alone, but based on, whew, I just got wrecked. Okay. So anyway, I guess we're gonna wind it down there for today's stream. Thanks for tuning in. We'll be back tomorrow, same time, same place. 5 o'clock to 7 o'clock U.S. Pacific time, and we should have a lot more items to play around with because the servers will be up. So thanks everyone for tuning in. If you missed any of the broadcast, it will go up on youtube.com/CaptainSparklez2, and you can watch the entirety of it on there, and as well as it'll be archived here on Twitch. So yeah, I guess that'll be it. Thanks again, guys. It has been fun, and I will see you all next time.